One of the proponents of the Maharlika Fund Bill at the lower house explains why they agreed to adopt the Senate version of the measure. Albay Representative Joey Salceda says the decision was made to allow the executive to begin crafting the rules and regulations of the measure. He adds they expect President Marcos to announce that he has signed it by his second State of the Nation address in July. Salceda also gave an assurance the MIF won't touch pension funds. He then suggested ways to refine its implementation, including allowing multilateral institutions like the World Bank to be strategic partners in the founding of the MIF. The bill seeking to create the Philippines' first ever sovereign wealth fund now awaits President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s signature. The 19th Congress swiftly passed the controversial Maharlika Investment Fund Bill Wednesday, with a bicameral committee sweeping aside persistent criticism against the president's pet measure to adopt the Senate's version.
We thank the House for accepting the Senate version with all these safeguards. Pwede po natin ipaglaban to sa Plaza Miranda.
Definitely hindi po siya political. Ito naman ay isang ay para sa ating ekonomiya. We'll ensure that the bill will at the Maharlika Fund will be very secure.
One of the major changes of the bill is keeping state pension funds out of the proposed sovereign wealth fund. President Marcos on Wednesday also allayed concerns over the sources of funding. But he did say he sees nothing wrong with state pension funds investing in the Maharlika Fund. One of the senators who voted in favor of the passage of the Maharlika Investment Fund Bill allays the public's concerns on the controversial measure. Senator Sherwin Gacharian believes lawmakers were able to put enough measures to protect the money of the Philippine government.
We have put safeguards to minimize the downside. The upside is there. But we put safeguards to make sure that public funds are protected and people who will abuse will be prosecuted. In fact, in the bill, there are 3 pages of penalties for those who will abuse the fund and those who will take advantage or corrupt officials in the fund. So in the Maharlika, in the MIF bill, it's important to note that there are 4 levels of audit that was prescribed in the bill. No? And this is one of the most, in my experience, both in the public and the private sector, it's one of the most airtight in terms of audit.
Asked what could happen if the Maharlika Fund fails, this is the senator's response.
Investment funds like this take a long view on investing. You don't look at 1 year, you don't look at 2 years, you look at 10 years, you look at longer than that. Definitely, economic activities are very cyclical. You can lose money today, but you can make a lot of money next year. You know? So you have to take a long view, especially the fund is not looking to make a quick buck. No? It's not designed to invest in stock market and cash out next month. No? It's designed to build the country. It's designed to contribute to economic development.
Another senator, meanwhile, explains his absence during the voting on the Maharlika Fund Bill. Senator Chiz Escudero says he did not expect his colleagues to finish deliberations on the wee hours of Wednesday. He adds he would have also voted against the measure.
Would have been no, because I was asking for a condition precedent, the test of economic viability, compliance with the common good definition as debated by the constitutional commissioners, and clarity with respect to purpose and reason why we're creating it, all of which they did not honor nor give. Simple lamang ang tanong ko at napag-usapan namin yan doon. Kung talagang bilib sila sa MIC, bakit nila pinagbawal yung mga gusto nilang protektahan na pension funds na mag-invest dyan? Dahil sa ngayon, hindi ko sinasabing duda sila. Pero sa ngayon, hanggang sa ngayon, marahil hindi pa sila ganun kakumbinsido na ito'y kikita talaga.
A Aside from Escudero, Senate Minority Leader Coco Pimentel and the President's sister, Aimee Marcos, were not present during the voting. 19 voted in favor, while Senator Risa Ontiveros was the lone no vote. Senator Nancy Binay abstained. The Japan Bank for International Cooperation expressing interest in the newly passed Maharlika Investment Fund. Malacanang says JBIC Chairman of the Board, Tadashi Maeda, paid a courtesy call on President Marcos Wednesday, where he congratulated the Philippine government on the approval of the MIF bill. The JBIC is also seeking partnerships with Philippine companies for energy development. Marcos first met with Madea during his official visit to Japan in February. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. and House Speaker Martin Romualdez now calling for unity following weeks of drama over an alleged ouster plot at the House of Representatives. Romualdez made the call in a speech before he adjourned the first regular session of the 19th Congress. The president's message of unity, meanwhile, came through a video message.
Pursuant to our shared vision of a strong republic, leaders of major political parties in this August halls have expressed their unwavering commitment to work together for the passage of the pro-people legislative agenda of President Ferdinand R. Marcos Jr.
Remain united, determined, and passionate. Be the voice of the people and fulfill your duty as servant leaders in your respective districts and provinces.
Earlier this week, several political parties reaffirmed their alliance with the Lakas CMD, which Romualdez leads. Vice President Sara Duterte had bolted the party, citing political toxicity. The House of Representatives, meanwhile, slaps new penalties against controversial lawmaker Arnolfo Teves Jr. Teves has been suspended for another 60 days over his continued absence in Congress. He was also stripped of all his committee memberships. Teves has been out of the country since late February. One of his colleagues again urged him to return home, saying his request for a political asylum in Timor-Leste affects the image of the Philippines.
Basically, in the United Nations, then all over the world, when you apply for refugee status, when you apply for political asylum, you are making the accusation that your country does A, not have the capability to offer protection for those persecuted, or that your own country is unwilling to provide protection for the persecuted.
Teves has been tagged by no less than the Justice Secretary as the main mastermind in the March 4 murder of Negros Oriental Governor Roel Degamo. One of the gunmen in the killing of a radio broadcaster in Calapan City remains at large. Police say a manhunt is underway to locate the suspect. Crescenciano Bundukin was shot dead outside his store early Wednesday by two motorcycle-riding assailants. One of the gunmen was able to flee the scene, while the other one was killed after sustaining a head injury when he fell off the motorcycle. Authorities say they are investigating if the killing of Bundukin is related to his profession.
Lahat po ay tinitingnan natin. Hindi po natin maaalis. Ang unang-unang inaangat namin dyan, yung personal grudge na maaaring may galit sa kanya. At pangalawa, yung kanyang profession as online media man. At yung pangatlo po, yung maaaring may business kasi siya, baka mayroon siyang kaalitan.
Bundukin had been outspoken about the oil spill that affected Oriental Mindoro, as well as on political issues. While the motive for his murder remains unclear, the National Union of Journalists of the Philippines says it serves as a grim reminder that journalism remains a dangerous profession in the country. The group calls on government to end attacks on journalists and bring the perpetrators to justice. Former President Rodrigo Duterte thumbing down calls for him to become the Marcos administration's drug czar. Duterte says he's not considering it since he wants to give way to his successor to address the country's narcotics problem. Duterte is facing a probe by the International Criminal Court for his bloody drug war that left at least 6,000 dead. President Marcos claims to have tweaked government's anti-drug campaign by focusing more on the rehabilitation of drug users.